I'm here with Annie at PowerGen. Annie, you've spent the last couple of days walking around the exhibition hall looking for companies using augmented reality, virtual reality, extended reality. What have you found?
Well, I found a few companies that are working in the space. Most of the applications have been to show off their machinery with product visualization tools. There's been one augmented reality experience I saw for scaffolding, and then I did see a power plant walkthrough as well with Rolls-Royce. So
okay.
There have been a few, but I will say again that they have been marketing related, so that's about as far as they've pushed it so far. But I've had a lot of conversations. People are excited about the tech at least.
You mentioned earlier that you spoke to a bunch of training organizations, companies,
yes,
and that they were quite excited about the technology.
Yes, I would say as opposed to the actual physical product manufacturers, the training organizations have been more excited, and I think it's because they see the future of interactive learning and training mm-hmm. going by way of virtual and augmented reality. So I'm excited to talk with people who get it, but educating people who don't has also been interesting.
But I saw on one of the stands inside where they had a virtual reality experience, you know, I'm a big believer in that. People have to try it. It's kind of hard to explain it to someone on a PowerPoint.
Mm-hmm.
And when they actually experience it and the immersiveness, it starts to open up opportunities, or even like some of the guys designing products, mm-hmm. servicing products, mm-hmm. training. They go, oh, God, we could do all sorts of things.
Yeah.
For companies that are starting down the path, now you've been at this for a while, right?
So, right.
But for some of the companies in here where things like augmented reality, virtual reality, the extended reality, whatever, mm-hmm. is not, it's new to them. What's your advice and where do they start? What do they do?
Just collecting all the information you can on what is in the existing industry is really important. Again, training and on-site assistance is huge right now with the space, and I think that's because it's turning into something that companies are able to prove as a solution to where it's increasing their efficiency, it's making communication easier, it's bringing digital information to site or maybe ahead of time in unsafe situations where they need that training and they can't physically do it on the site.
Mm-hmm.
Just exploring what other companies have been doing and then learning from those applications is the best way to start. There are a lot of online resources for that. I mean, even Reddit is an amazing resource for just an aggregation of the type of applications that are out there and mm-hmm. what's being published. But I'd say start by seeing what other people are doing and then start brainstorming on what would apply best to your business.
And last point, in terms of mass adoption, there's a lot of stuff, you know, Apple and Google are bringing a lot of AR capabilities and stuff to the smartphone.
Mm-hmm.
And what often happens is that people don't, how would you say, it's like a Trojan horse. They kind of go, oh, that's a cool app.
Mm-hmm.
They're not really sure it's AR, but they get a cool experience.
Yeah.
As more and more of those AR type apps appear in the Play Store and in iTunes, do you think that will change, how would you say, public perception? Or will the next generation of workers kind of go, hey, why aren't we doing this? We need some of this kind of technology in our company.
Yeah, I spoke actually with quite a few young professionals in the power industry last night, and it's really great to hear that they already understand it and they feel like they're looking for these opportunities
right.
to add this to their businesses. I think those people who are looking to advance with maybe a more established company are going to have success in bringing these ideas to their leadership teams. I know hardware has been a limitation for quite some time because it's so expensive. With devices like the Microsoft HoloLens, mm-hmm. HTC 5, Magic Leap, they're all amazing platforms, but you really have to have the right use case to justify the cost. So with what Apple and Google are doing with ARKit and AR Core, those are amazing ways to hit a market who already has the hardware, and those can be powerful as well. There are remote troubleshooting tools with annotation capabilities that are in AR. There are ways to bring in information from safety manuals, operation manuals, and have those pieces of information directly mapped to the physical equipment you're working on,
mm-hmm.
all through a phone. So when people say hardware is a limitation, I feel like they need to think about it differently and find ways around it because the ways are there.
No, agreed. Hey, I wish you well. Take care.
Thank you so much.